All right, here we go. Welcome to Saturday Night Forum with the one and only Via. Woo, come on now, let's hear it for her. I am DJ. So, first of all, I want to make sure that we could hear. So, Via, can you talk and let's comment if you could hear Via. Via, can you introduce yourself? Say hello. Can you guys hear Via? If you guys could put it down there. Let me know if you guys could put it in the comments. Wait, check if you could hear Via.
I did.
You didn't hear Via. You heard me.
Okay.
Hold on. Let's see. No?
No.
Okay. So I got to let me move off of.
Yeah, I can hear
you. Okay, we can't hear you. Let's see. Via, can you talk? Oh, hold on.
Okay, I can hear her now. Just let it higher the
volume. Right. I heard myself.
There you go. Can you hear yourself now?
Hi.
There we go. Awesome.
Hello?
Can you guys hear her?
Can you guys hear Via?
Put in the comments if you could hear me or Via and my beautiful wife right here. Come on, let us know if you could hear us. First time using this technology.
Mm-hmm.
Comment below, can you hear?
No.
No.
No. Oh my.
Okay, wait, let me see. Can't hear Ate Via, no. Maybe that was the earlier one.
Oh yeah, that was the earlier one.
Oh. How about now?
You guys can put it in the comments. Yeah, it's a delay.
Yeah, it's a delay.
Can't hear. All right. Don't worry. We're figuring it out. Let's try it again.
Yep.
Can you do sound check? Yeah, can you talk?
Sound check. Check. Sound check. check. Via Antonio Ruiz. Sound check. How to deal with anxiety. Saturday. Sorry.
Are you having anxiety right now?
We're having anxiety.
A bit. A general anxiety.
Let's see. No, try talk.
Okay. Guys, can you hear me now? I hope that you do. Check, black. Mic, check. Mic, check. Sound check.
There we go.
Go.
Yeah.
Okay.
Awesome.
Yay!
Woo! We got it. Hey. Awesome. It's so good. I'm so glad you're here, Via. Oh my gosh. It is amazing to have you on Saturday Night Forum. And so we got a great crowd ready for you. Come on, how are you guys doing? You guys doing well? Awesome. So, Via, thank you for joining. Thank you for being part of the Inspire family. Thank you for just your energy and your personality and your faithfulness and your heart.
And
your passion. And Jonah and Keo. Thank you for the world. And if you guys are not familiar with Via, let me just share you a bio. She'll be logging on one more time. I think it's just a little delay. But Via is a mother and she's an amazing wife. She's a theater actress, TV film, performer, singer, dancer, host, commercial model, influencer, endorser, cornerstone management artist. She's a servant leader, a connect group coach here in Inspire Church Metro Ministry. She's on the worship team. She's in counseling and inner healing ministry. She's it everywhere in part of the church. She also has her BA in theater arts, and she's formerly from UP Diliman, alumni there of the Pep Squad,
yeah.
UP Theater Council,
mm-hmm.
and now she is currently taking up her MA, her master's in counseling in Alliance. What is that sound? In Alliance Graduate School, AGS. She's also a member of Family and Pastoral Counselor Association of the Philippines and Philippine Association of Christian Counselors. And she is also a certified health initial responder and mental wellness advocate. And so, man, she has so many things going on. She is doing well. She is going to be our guest for today, Saturday Night Forum. What we will be focusing on today is real simple,
mm-hmm.
is we want to help each other during this time. If you have anxiety, if you have things going on, mental health, I would love for you to chime in. I would love for you to help us with any questions
that
you've got.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
We got a lot of people viewing in here in Facebook Live. And so we're just going to get her back in. She was just on a flight from Dubai. And so her Wi-Fi is a little short up there, but it's going to be a good time. We got a couple of questions already lined up.
Yeah, but if you have additional questions, go ahead and type it in, and we are going to make sure to answer them.
Yeah. And so we're going to answer the questions for you tonight.
There we go.
Via's back.
Technology.
Awesome, awesome. How was your flight from Dubai?
It's fine. Sorry.
Yeah, great.
There. Can you hear me now?
Yes.
I needed to shift from my iPad to phone, so it will come from Globe, my data from Globe.
Oh, wow.
Oh, wow.
Awesome, awesome. So I just shared all of your just skills and passion and all of those things. What are you up to during this whole quarantine? How's life doing? What's going on?
Well, for me, there will be two types of persons like during this time around. We are on our third week of our quarantine, and I think I can say that I am settled with a new set of habits, and I am slowly getting by the new norm.
Uh-huh.
I wake up doing these things, and then at 5 o'clock, I make sure that I'll have my self-care via the workouts that I am watching over the internet, and then reading time perhaps, and then of course my favorite is the eating time with my family. So I prepare food for them.
Wow.
Yeah, things that I wasn't really doing before, because you know, I had a busy lifestyle before, so I don't have any excuses right now. So getting by the routines in life.
Wow.
There we go. How's everything? How's the workouts going? I see you and Jonah working out like 24/7.
Yeah, I never imagined I can inspire him doing those lifts and everything. So I got motivated. I had a mini gym. Yes, I invested, but some konti lang, because I know that I'll be back in the gym once the quarantine will be lifted.
Yeah.
So what do you think is one of the main things that people go through during this quarantine when it comes to worry, when it comes to anxiety? I mean, our whole theme right now is how do we deal with anxiety? How do we lessen it? Can it disappear? My dog has anxiety right now, and so, what do you think? You know, because some people are in their homes and they might be thinking, "I'm the only one. Nobody understands." Can you just give us a summary of what emotions people would be feeling during this time?
Mm-hmm. I think this is the perfect moment to say that we would love to normalize the feeling of being anxious. There are three primary emotions that people feel nowadays. It's being fearful of the uncertainties,
right?
Of course, the anxieties and panic. So I would like to take this opportunity to say that all our emotions right now, you know, the anxious hearts that we have, this is normal. And kaya nga meron tayong ano, we are connected somehow, because as you fall in line in the groceries, you have the same language of really, you know, having the panicky kind of look in your face. So I want to start with fear.
Yeah.
Fear is defined in the DSM, or the Diagnostic and Statistical Manual of Mental Disorders, as emotional response to real or perceived imminent threat. So right now, what's happening around us, how easy it was before to get or to grab milk or to grab snacks or have yourselves order McDonald's, it's much harder right now.
Right.
So it's really, this is a real feeling that it is a response of us. And of course, anxiety is defined as anticipation of future threat. So we all do not know what's going to happen next. Kaya ba ng government natin? Some of us are politically triggered, not just for our own health. Of course, yeah, if we have it, do we have the virus? Are we just asymptomatic? How do we pass it on? Or not just about the worries and the anxieties for ourselves, but of course, for our whole family and for the whole globe. You know, this is a global disaster. So it is natural as we relate things now, how we do we before, like all the coffee shops are closed,
right?
And that adds up anxiety to us, Pastor Nolan and Pastor Judy, that how I miss machine-based coffee. Those are the things that, and of course, the procedural learning experience that we are having now. So before we go out to actually get our laundries, we should put masks, we should put alcohol, we have to sanitize, you know, things like this. So it really is a normal feeling. I would like to take this platform to say that it's just normal, and that you are not crazy, and that we are together fighting against the anxiety. So it's so nice to have this kind of platform to really share how to quiet it down a bit, or how to like manage our anxieties as a church and as a community.
Right. I think the best way is to handle anxiety is to eat. Just kidding.
Emotional eating. Of course.
Emotional eating. I've been eating so much, Z. See, I called you Z.
That's anxiety.
That's my anxiety.
I look like Z. Anxiety.
Okay, so do you want to go through the questions right now? There's a lot of questions that people have been asking.
Yeah. Wow. Okay, I actually prepared. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Seven. Actually, no, yeah, you go first, and then we'll go Q&A
okay.
after.
All right, that would be nice, because I prepared actually 7 practical tips that that worked for me.
There
because
we go.
During the first week of quarantine, I was literally, my mouth was open and I didn't know what to do, what's gonna happen. Daddy's girl would tape soon, or are we freezing the movie that I am in? So a lot of things. I just needed 7 days, practically 1 week, to just be by myself, parang ganun. So I was so messed up, like a lot of things happened. But during the second week, I managed to really sit down on it, and I dealt with the anxieties, and I wrote down some of the practical tips that can help you guys.
Yeah, please.
So can I start now, Pastor?
Yes, would love to.
All right. So So, number one is, I think, yun nga, there are two types of people nowadays. So, since we are on their 21st day of quarantine, some have mentally adjusted and they've created their habits. Like, what time do they wake up? What are the things that they need to accomplish in a day? And the second one are the people who are, I call it quarantine. Or quarantine fatigue. Or moral fatigue. Because after, of course, weeks of hearing no coming out, no jogging, no meeting of friends, you know, these things, it tires them. So, two types. Then I think I fell in the... I am falling in the first category, which in I am settling in into a new normal. So, number one, I would like to quote my favorite clinical psychologist, Dr. Ramani, because when I heard her saying this, this practically, I started with routine. Number one is to have your routine. Habits like waking up and what are the three things that you have to do. Okay, I wanna prepare lunch. Then I want to work out and I want to watch my favorite series. So those three routines that would help you have your self-care for at least the next 3 days. So, and of course, we all have different kinds of routines. So mothers would clean the kitchen, or you wanna wash your laundry and so forth. So this would give us the security for the next 10 days. We have 10 days more. So if you haven't gotten yourselves routine, now is the perfect time for you to just, oh, these are the things that I have to do. Second is set realistic goals. So the list of things to do, like number one, kasi you have to take note of your own pacing. Sometimes you feel like, it's been 30 days na walang classes, so I have to fix my closet, or I want to alphabetize my journal stickers, or things like that. So you have to be kinder to yourself by setting realistic goals. Like, when I wake up, I wanna wash half of my laundry basket. So, you know, be realistic as much as possible.
Right.
And these are the lists, of course, that you have to check as the day ends. So, meaning you have to celebrate your little wins and victories for the day. So, you'll feel happy there. Third is, what happened to me is, if there's social distancing, I experience social media distancing. Because as I sorted things that can make me anxious, it is getting all the information and news that I want. So, I needed to cut down the noise a bit, because so I just needed to I said goodbye to some of my chat groups, mainly you would assess it if it's toxic for me or if it's positive for you. So social media distancing, you know, guys, what I mean. Fourth is, as we have it in the church, I stay connected with my friends.
Great.
Some of my friends back then, I usually have excuses na I don't have time to meet you guys. But I think during the 21 day, and the days are counting pa, so let's use the time to connect with people that we don't normally see, like high school friends, or anyone that can add positiveness in your life. So be connected, because we are wired to be socializing, and we are not wired to isolate. So this is not the time to isolate.
Great.
So you are not alone in this journey.
Right.
Next is be busy with boosting your immune system, and you gotta stay healthy. So I found myself busying, seeing a lot of YouTube videos on how to have abs, or how to boost my immune system, what are the things to drink, to take, what are the natural immune system boosters, and turmeric and ginger tea and whatever. I just busied myself, because at the end of the day, we are stewards of our body, and with or without COVID-19, it's always it's a benefit. I mean, we need to take care of ourselves with or without COVID, because we know that even after the quarantine has been lifted, we need to, the virus or another type of virus will be, you know, will happen, can happen. So it's better to just be secured with your physical health, because stress, however, can actually it does a lot of bad things in our immune system. Stresses can make our immune system slow down,
right?
And it's gonna be less efficient. So with the physical health, with healthy physical health comes, of course, the mental health. We have to eat. Yeah, that's what you said a while ago, Pastor. So eat all the foods that you can think and you crave. Hydrate yourself. More water, more fun. And of course, you gotta have a lot of rest.
Mm.
Yeah, because we don't have work tomorrow, so we rest. So, you know, the 8-hour sleeping habit can be the best time for now. So it's not being tamad or lazy, but you need that, because when we are during the waking hours, our minds would really go faster as it was before because of the anxieties and
right.
So yeah, be very mindful of your health in all aspects, and of course the spiritual aspect, that you need a community and you need more the power of the Lord through prayer.
Mm-hmm.
Fifth, number five is I want to anchor it through what we are saying in our church, that while we build, while we wait, we build.
Right.
So in a corporal setup or in a church setup, I know that after the quarantine, there are a lot of things to celebrate and to be excited about. Like, we are moving, right? So from that excitement, I want you to just narrow it down to yourself. Like, who is Via after the quarantine? Who is Pastor Nolan after 30?
Wow, that's good.
I mean, what do you want to be? So I wanted to be the better version of myself in all aspects. I wanna be able to be stronger. And I think that's a collective dream for everyone, right? So while we wait for the days, let's not count the days, but let's make the days count by having the last 10 days be fruitful and productive. So this is the perfect time to make a new habit, mag-crochet ka, you wanna do, you know, things like that. So they say that it's easier to learn a new habit than to change a bad habit, right? So
right.
This is the perfect moment that while we wait for the quarantine to be lifted, we build ourselves.
So good.
You know,
so
good. Set goals for yourselves. And next. I think this is the last. Actually, the orders, Past Jay and Past Nolan, can be intertwined, or you can actually start from whatever.
Yeah.
Depends on your personality or what you need to alleviate your anxieties and stress. But I think the last one that I'll share is, this can come as your first. Number seven is to choose your battles.
So good.
I know that we will start. I personally experience choosing the internal battles that I have, because as I've said a while ago, some of us are politically triggered, and sometimes it's really hard to fight for our nation, but it can start with ourselves, because this is the only vessel that we can control. We can't control the responses of our husbands, of our wives, of our sons and daughters, and our whole family. So what the only thing that can how to deal with anxiety is to break down the anxiety, know where is it coming from. You have to deconstruct it, like cooking. So you have to be mindful of the things around you. So know your battlefield, know your triggers. Okay, so watching this video about going to the groceries can add up to my anxieties, because I just came from the grocery. So parang you have to choose it, like, okay, this is not the perfect time to read about this news, so I'll just go back to this when I am okay. So you gotta know your triggers. And after knowing your triggers, you gotta know your coping styles. Because we do have different coping styles. I found self-care in solitude being the best company for myself. Yes, as a social butterfly, I managed to know myself na I am comfortable being alone nowadays. So Yeah, coping styles means having your own self-care. Like you plan to take a bath for 20 minutes, your time alone, or anything, any coping styles. We don't need to judge the coping styles of other people. So there you go. And we just need to remember that psychologically, physically and spiritually, we need to be prepared for the changes that will happen, because we don't know yet of the uncertainties that will happen after this quarantine. I know that things will not be the same, and that's a reality, but it's better to be prepared,
right,
in all aspects of our life.
Yeah,
there
you
go.
Good.
So I'll just, yeah, that's it.
So good. Wow. I need all that information.
I know.
1 to 7practical
tips. Thank you, guys.
I mean, when you were thinking about that, and when you were thinking about, you know, just the different ways of coping, or just
yeah,
the different ways of dealing with anxiety, I mean, what do you think? What do you think about when how do I say this? How do you know when you are coping, or when you are just running away?
Numbing yourself.
Coping versus numbing.
Yes. Okay. The more you resist, or the more that you deny, the more you deny your anxieties or your fears, the more it will stay, and the more it becomes dangerous. So when you feel you're stressed with, for example, you were watching you're watching TV, and then a news suddenly triggered you. So face it. You have to deal with it. And then you have to grieve and cry, because there are a lot of times that I cried, like during the 21 days through quarantine, news made me cry. I mean, that's my story. So I face it, I deal with it, like, where is it coming from? I actually, my anxiety would come always from the health scare, because I know that this has been the most healthiest state of my life. But then this COVID came in town, and so it triggered me so much that sabi ko nga, if there are a lot of years na I wasn't thinking about my health, you know? But I think my anxiety is coming from the health. So there are times that I would switch off the TV, but then self-talk, self-reflection is very important nowadays, because you really need to assess whether you are running away, you're denying. You would know kasi if you're denying. So I'm okay, I'm practically fine, I'm very happy with what I have, but it bugs you, and you can waste half of the day thinking about just that. So I think my number one tip is just to face it. Grieve. We all grieve, because there's no small or big losses. We all lost a lot of things. Like, a lot of high school students didn't have their graduation, prom, and, you know, the Holy Week, we were planning to have a beach trip, but we can't anymore. So, yeah, these things, these losses that we have to face, and we have to grieve, and we have to cry, to cry out.
Good. That's
yes,
really good.
That's so good.
So get out of your denial, right?
Yes.
Because if you are in denial, that's called numbing, correct?
Yeah. Yes, yes. But
so it's so good. Self-talk. So you gotta process, in a sense.
Yes,
for
process.
For you to know that you're not just numbing yourself. Instead, you're on your way to that healing. It's
yeah,
so good, yeah?
Yeah.
Is there any more questions?
Yeah, we got a lot of questions. Is it okay I start asking you some questions?
I like that first one.
Here's a good one. This one is from anonymous. It's my family gives me anxiety. How do I handle this during lockdown?
Okay, my God. This, as Dr. Romani would put it into words, this is a nice workout for any relationship, for marital relationships, and of course, the reality that our parents or our brothers and sisters would add up to the anxieties, because we have different kinds of personalities. And before, when we feel like annoyed, you can go out, like, right? But now you gotta stick with them and you're stuck. So what I think what I do, or what we can do, is to set psychological boundaries. Like, if this person annoys you, you gotta check if is this my issue or his or her issues, because she's bored or she's, I mean, you gotta stretch your understanding, because we are all feeling anxious at the same time. So your empathic response would really be working out nowadays. So you have to just assess, is this your issue or is this my issue? If it's not my issue, then that's practically your problem. So I'll have a shield, a boundary that, okay, you are just bored and I'm not gonna be hurt with what you said.
That's really good.
So I think it's setting, and good communication can be practiced nowadays na. Medyo, yeah, that happened to me, because my mom, one time, kasi nga, di ba, we are working out every afternoon, and Kiyo would practice with his football,
right.
Football training. Yeah, he's practicing with football. And sometimes my mom, just like an old classic grandma, would say, don't perspire, kasi nga, you would catch colds or even the virus like that. So there was one time when Kiyo woke up very late, and we were eating downstairs, and then sabi niya, oh my god, you gotta check Kiyo because maybe he's not feeling well due to the perspiration and the sweat last night. So parang I got anxious na, you don't say these things nowadays, because yeah, as I've said a while ago, the health scare would really add up to my anxiety. So you don't say anything about fever or not feeling well in this house. So I immediately rebuked and all these spiritual warfare. So I told her immediately, now not those things nowadays are not supposed to be said. Mm-hmm. Kasi nga, we have to be cautious of our of the things that we say, because it can add up to anxiety. So siya naman, she said that she's just caring for Kiyo, and yeah so I think communication, saying it nicely and why, you know, the reason behind it would clear things.
Yeah, that's so good. So I mean, good. Communication, right? I love what you said about just boundaries and psychological boundaries. I never heard that before, but I mean, that's really, really such a great tip, that you are trying to understand where they're coming from before you snap, in a sense, or before you get upset. And
yes, because it's hard to argue with your parents nowadays, because you gotta say sorry after a day, or else you're not gonna eat rice.
Here's another one. Here's a good one. When is the point you need or you have to go to a psychiatrist or a counselor?
Yes. So anyone can actually go to someone or to connect with someone to debrief you or to process things. Now is the perfect time. There's no standard na I am thinking of suicidal thoughts, so I have a reason to go to the psychiatrist or counselors. But any moment, like right now, if you are handling general anxiety or the chronic anxiety, we have free online to talk with you. You know, cathartic moment, or you just need to express the feeling of anxiety or your emotions, if the overwhelming fear and anxiety, you just need someone to connect your thoughts with. Like, as I've said a while ago, be connected. Choose a friend who's very empathic, who will not judge you, and just say things to her, and magically you'll have a clear heart and you have a lighter feeling. So, counselors nowadays and psychiatrists, I've seen two, I think, I don't know, I'm just not sure kung what hospital that is, but they have free consultations with psychiatrists, and AGS from Alliance Graduate School is having, is starting a free online debriefing April 6th. That's on Monday, up to May. So you gotta coordinate and register. So anyone in the world right now can talk to someone else and unload stuff that bothers them.
Wow.
Yeah, I mean,
prevention is better than cure.
Yes.
Yeah, I mean, that's exactly what I was thinking. If you are thinking about, should I see a counselor or should I see a psychiatrist? I mean, there's such a stigma in our country here where either you are weak or, you know, it's not that bad. You're just overthinking or just, you know, maarte lang, right?
Yes.
Maarte ka
lang.
Exactly. And I really believe that preventive medicine is better than trying to find a cure.
Right.
And so if you have feelings of, you know, anxiety, depression, any of those things, you can't do it alone. I mean,
yes.
And you should, I believe you should, you know, hit at it in different ways. One, of course, you should go to church. If you don't go to church already, a church where, you know, it's more relational than just religion. And then go to a connect group, because you got to be with other people or a small group.
Yep.
And once you build that connection, you can share what's going on, ask for prayer. Most of the time, things get solved in that area.
Yeah.
Right. But then if it's deeper issues, then you know, if those don't help, that's already counseling in a sense. If those don't help, then you should go get professional counseling.
Yeah, invest in
you. Yeah, it's an investment. I mean, how many people go get massage, right? After a long day. You know, save up those massages. So, save up 2 to 3 massage. Save up some coffee.
Yes.
And get some, you know, get some mental massages.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And so that's really good. Yeah. Here's another question for you. What is the first thing you need to do when you're anxious? Or let me put this also. What's the first thing you need to do when you feel like you're having a panic attack?
Yeah.
Okay. So number one, breathing is really connected with what we do, right? So when we're happy, our heartbeat races and our breathing changes. So it's the same thing with panic attacks. So there are a lot of breathing exercises that we can do, because I had experienced an attack before. Then I assessed it if it's the real thing or it's just an anxiety attack. So breathing, number one, breathing exercise. You gotta count 1 to 8, inhale, and then 1 to 8, release, exhale. So that would work. And then second is the grounding, that you are not somewhere else, that you are in this point in time wherein you can see and you can touch and you can smell and you can hear things. So grounding, that grounding can help you.
Yeah.
So those are just two exercises that you can. And of course, lastly is the self-talk. Once you've grounded, like I've heard this from Jay Shetty, a motivational speaker, that you gotta exhale more time than you inhale. So that gives 1, 2, 3, 4 to inhale, and then exhale for 8 counts. So that would bring you back and normalize or regulate your anxiety. And once your breathing is okay, so you got to choose, I wrote that down. 5 things you see, 4 things you can touch, 3 things that you can hear, 2 things that you can smell, and 1 thing that you can taste. After those 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, eventually you'd realize that, okay, I am in present time, and that's just an attack because of, brought by the anxiety.
Can you say that again so that for our note takers? That's really good.
Yeah. 5, gotta think, 5 things you see, 4 things you touch, 3 things you hear, two things you smell and one thing you taste. So that came from Jay Shetty, a motivational speaker.
Bringing you
so,
back to reality, yeah.
Yeah,
yes,
getting
grounding.
You, yeah, grounding. I like that.
Yes. If you are with someone, try to hold or grasp her hand, or, you know, just to make you be reminded that you are in the present time and you are not on the future or in the past.
Mm-hmm. So true. Yeah. Here's a good question. We got this question messaged in. It goes, I'm actually already watching you live, so my question is there really times that I suddenly feel empty inside. I don't know what triggers it, but I feel like no matter how many people are surrounding me, even my family, I'll still feel empty and really sad, like something is missing, and I don't know what it is. When I feel empty, I don't feel like talking to my friends, I don't feel like working, and I don't really feel good about it. My heart's so heavy during this time. I would like some advice on how to deal with it in case it will occur again.
Okay. So, with or without the COVID-19, pastors, and the person who asked that question, the stresses and the anxiety or the anxious world that we are right now is really pushing us further. Like, if you are... you have that mental health condition even before the COVID, it triples, it doubles, you know. So what, as we said a while ago, it's really best to go to a professional,
right,
to really sort things out, because with or without the mental health condition, the world or the uncertainties would kill us. Thinking about the anticipated threats that's about to happen, our minds are not that good in comprehension, right? So it's better, and it's actually best to connect with a professional. So this is the perfect time because there are free consultations. I think it is very valid to feel the emptiness because this is the first time that we are experiencing social distancing. What's supposed to be precious before, like a beso or a hug, we are wired and we are built to have that, you know. It's a sense of connection and love and tenderness, right? So right now that if you're getting it from your friends and we are not allowed to meet and to be or physically in touch with them, so you will feel the emptiness and the isolation and that you want to withdraw from the world. So it's best to seek for a professional, so your emotions and all those things, because talking to a professional might help you to sort things up. It can be from the past, from your childhood, or you gotta know the trigger. So all the things that I've mentioned a while ago can be done with a professional or with a counselor or with a psychiatrist. But best if a good friend, you think of a good friend that you can easily talk to nowadays, and then eventually my tip for you is to really consult a professional so that you would you'd know what's happening.
Yeah, I mean, definitely. I mean, professional counseling has helped me just immensely, you know, and
yeah,
to be able to understand my emotions, to be able to understand those times of depression or those feelings. For that person who sent that message, I just want to say we just want to thank you for your bravery, for sharing that. One of the good things is that you are self-aware enough to know that there's something wrong. It would be harder if you didn't even realize it, and you're just walking in a cave. But because you know you are walking in a cave, you are headed towards the right direction.
Yeah, it's half of the battle, knowing.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, and so I just want to encourage you that, number one, I want you to just talk to God. I'm not sure what type of relationship you have with God or what type of culture you were raised up in, but God is open. God is there to just listen to you. You don't have to say a formal prayer. You could just talk to him in any way, even one sentence, he could minister to you. So I would encourage you to talk to God and ask him to help you. Ask him to have a relationship with him. If you already have a relationship with God, then I want you to know that what Via also said was, yeah, you need to get counseling.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
There's nothing wrong with counseling. Mm-hmm. Just from your description, Via, is it safe to say just from that description of feeling empty, feeling all of a sudden just down all of a sudden, unable to work? I mean,
it falls. Mm-hmm. It falls in a, those are some of the symptoms that would mean there's a mental health condition that we have to pay attention to. And with or without it, I just want to add up to the stigma that we have here in the Philippines about consulting counselors. It is good with your self-awareness. I mean, the triggers and the tendencies that you have. So even after the COVID, you found yourself that you have an anxious spirit. So it's really, everyone should get counselors, Pastor.
Yeah.
And of course, spiritual family, just like what you said, and a personal relationship with God. Because sabi nga ni God, okay, so you are having now free online debriefing. So that's what I'm doing for several thousand years ago already. So it's a free call. If you want to just unload to God,
mm-hmm.
what you're feeling, ask and cry out for help from him.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah,
so
that's
good.
Nice, Pastor.
That's really good.
Yeah. I mean, like you were sharing, just the stigma behind mental health, even that word alone, mental health, you know,
mm-hmm.
could bring different pictures to mind. It could bring,
mm-hmm.
I remember watching a mental health video, commercial before the movies. Right. And so I totally understand what they're trying to do. They're trying to make it normal.
Mm-hmm.
But even their expression looks scary.
Yeah.
Right. Like they're like, you know,
yeah.
even if they're trying to make it look like normal, but their expressions in acting make it look like you're scared. You're like, ay, grabe, depression.
Yeah.
But.
Yes.
There's negative connotations
mm-hmm.
to what it means to have
mm-hmm.
mental health or be depressed or all of that. But a lot of times, the person that is smiling could also deal with mental health.
Mm-hmm.
The person that jokes
exactly.
a lot can deal with mental health. The most popular person in your workplace or in your school could deal with mental health.
Have it, yeah.
I mean, and so don't be afraid of that word if there's a problem with your mental health, because there's nothing to be afraid of. It's just something
right.
that you
yes.
want to grow in and deal with and
yeah.
heal
yes.
from.
It's part of life, you know?
Yes.
Yeah.
Anxiety, like we really treat it as a virus or like a disease.
Like
yeah. we're scared of it. But then it's, in actuality, it's kind of like an indicator that there's something wrong with
yes.
our habits or whatnot, right? So
right.
we got to stop the stigma on that. So
yes.
thank you.
And
yeah.
just...
Yeah.
And just to link mental health with physical health, if you have the symptoms of the COVID, like you're coughing, you have fever, you have shortness of breath, these are the symptoms. That's why you go to ER and let yourself check, right? So the symptoms in the mental health is having those feelings of anxieties, overwhelming fear, panic attacks. These are the same. So as long as you're investing with your physical health, it must be the same with mental health, that
right.
you have to invest on a counselor, let your health yourselves check.
Mm-hmm.
So that's it.
Yeah, I mean,
it's the same.
Yes.
It's equally important.
Yeah, I mean, there was a time, what was it, a couple of years ago? How many years ago before I got checked?
Four, five.
Probably about, that's my kids. probably 5 years ago, 5 years ago or longer, ever since I was in high school or even beyond high school, I would remember, you know, being anxious, being worried, you know, trying to figure things out, sad, and
suicidal.
At times in high school, a little suicidal, you know, just thinking about it, but not not trying to act it out.
Mm-hmm.
But I remember just, you know, talking to myself and saying, what's wrong with you? You know, just trying to push it through, push it away, right? and just suppress it, right? It's just an emotion that that you want to just submit it, right, to whatever. And then after a while, got coming up, you know, graduating college, working, and then even when I'm a pastor now, even when I was, you know, leading a church, have a family, there would be times where it would come up, and you would think that maybe I don't have enough faith. Am I not praying enough? Right? And so of course that guilt trip comes in. You beat yourself up. And so there was a time where I think it was my pastor recommended, hey, go see our counselor. And so I went to go see our counselor, and he goes, oh, this is simple, Nolan. I go, what? What's going on? He goes, you have anxiety. And I was like, wait, what? Right? And he goes, yeah, this is general anxiety. You've already done counseling before. You've already done, you know God. You have a great support group. So the only thing that's wrong now is just your levels. What's that called? Your chemical levels.
Chemical imbalance.
Yeah, there's a chemical imbalance that's just causing you to have this anxiety now because of the way you were raised, the way you grew up,
the traumas
in life. And so all she did was, okay, here, take this medicine. But here, is that not faith? Is that right? Is that,
Yeah.
But that's like saying, my ubo ako, but I don't want to take Robitussin, right? Or I don't want to take, because it's not faith. And so I started taking that medicine, and ayun, my levels are normal now. And I'm still abnormal sometimes, but my levels are normal. And so if you're in the chat, or you're watching this live stream, hey, get counseling. There's nothing wrong with it. If you keep dealing with anxiety over and over and over again, it's time to get professional help. And it's okay. You got a church with you. Go to inspiremetro.live, get connected.
I think that's one of the things. Get connected. Because it's hard for you to rewire or redirect your mind if your environment is constantly giving you the toxicity. So it's time for a new environment. The best way for you to do that is surround yourself with people who has that positive, output in life, right? Like, go to inspiremetro.live.
Yeah.
Get an internet group that will bring life rather than death in your thoughts.
Exactly.
Talk to Via. She's...
Yeah.
Get that free counseling if you can, right? Yeah. Via, maybe you could share with us. We'll share it on Inspire Metro, free counseling sessions for those of us that want to.
Yes, please.
Okay.
Yeah, please. Let. Where do we go?
You could send it to us.
I'll be sending the posters with the contact numbers of according to the day that they're free.
Okay.
So,
okay.
Yeah.
So just
Monday to Saturday, we've got counselors waiting for you guys.
Awesome. So we're gonna end it now. Thank you for just hanging out. I want you to give us a last closing statement, an encouraging word. Someone is there from the viewers who've been coming in and out. Maybe someone just logged in right now. Is at the end of this whole time. What's a word that you think God is speaking to you to speak to them right now?
Well, as I've said a while ago, just a recap, that what you're feeling right now is valid. Do not think that you are alone in this battle. We are all same. We're all feeling anxious. Having that fear of the unknown, of the uncertainties is normal. But don't go to the panic mode because... of suppressing the fear and the anxiety. You gotta face it. You gotta deal it. And just remember, or pick 3 or 4 out of the 7 practical tips that I've shared to you. But I wanna leave you with the 3 P's. That's important more than anything.
Please.
And you gotta deal with these three P's under the crisis.
Okay.
Because we know that even as they lift quarantine, we need to really be vigilant and very, we have to observe, because we can't see the virus. We don't know yet, and we don't have the vaccine yet. So we really need to be boosting our immune systems, thinking about our physical and our mental and spiritual health. So three P's are peace.
Peace.
This is important. You gotta know the triggers that would spoil your peace or would rob peace. And think of the styles or the coping styles or how to manage anxieties for you to have the peace. And
peace.
Nobody would ever judge you if peace means being alone in the bathroom for 2 hours, just, you know, having that peace. Second is productivity. Make sure that you're fruitful. Make sure that you are not thinking about the quarantine as vacation or free time or to rest so much. So if you are resting too much, then that is also one of the symptoms that you are denying or you're numbing. So you gotta assess yourself if am I just denying or I'm just so exhausted. So you gotta just be honest with yourself that, okay, I want rest because I feel exhausted, because I feel anxious. So yeah, productivity. And next is pleasure. So pleasure, think about the things that makes you happy. Avoid things that would trigger you, like the news, the political things that's happening in the social media. If you don't want too much information about it. But of course, let yourselves be, you gotta be informed of the things to do or not to do, right? So there, secure yourself for you to have that strong foundation for you to be able to help and to reach out, right? So you gotta be stronger. It's like an analogy of, I think, how can you save if you cannot save yourself, right? And you have to embrace the new norm. You gotta be thinking ahead of, yeah, from Pastor Mike, that we have to pack. Dr. Sam Chan, you have to pack for the future. Mm-hmm. And you got to be prepared in all aspects. And self-talk, self-reflect, and connect with your friends and with new friends. It's time for us to meet new friends and the support system that Inspire Church is offering you guys. So, yeah, you got all that you need, and we hope that we gave you light this afternoon, this evening, that you are not alone in this battle, and no one should do life alone. We are wired to be together and to be connected, and we are here for you guys.
Awesome. Via, how can people get connected with you online?
You can follow me with my IG. It's MS Via Antonio. And of course, I am also in Facebook, V An Ru. That's
how
my
is that
other
how?
Name.
V-E-E,
and then space An, space R-O-O. That's my Facebook. But I think I can accommodate you in IG. I actually respond more in IG.
Awesome.
Wow.
Thank you so much for doing this, pastors. Thank you for thinking about this platform to be of help or to serve other people.
Yeah.
Dealing with anxieties, because we all are.
Yeah, this is
no
just,
one's excuse.
Exactly. I mean, I just wanted to spend this time with you for, you know, free counseling for myself and without paying. So thank you for letting me use you for this past hour.
Those are your questions, pala.
Those are all my questions. Well, those viewing us on Inspire Church Metro Facebook Live, we just want to thank you for tuning in. We've got a lot of people just interacting. Hey, get to know each other. Don't forget to check out inspiremetro.live. We got Sunday service experience, Sunday's best tomorrow.
Yeah.
11 a.m., 3 p.m., 5 p.m., and 7 p.m. And so please get connected. Fill out a Next Steps card out there. Join a Connect group. Just let us know if you're looking for counseling and you didn't get where to get connected. Hey, message us on Facebook and we will connect you to the right person. Well, thank you all for joining us. It was a sweet time. We'll see you next time for our Saturday Night Forum. Tune in on Wednesday is Living Room Lounging with the Galitos. Maybe my wife will cut my hair. I'm not sure. We're going to have a great time there. Maybe I'll cut my wife's hair. But thank you guys for tuning in. We will see you again
very soon.
Thank you, Via.
Thank you, Pastor Pastor Nolan.
Bye, guys.
God bless, guys.